家好，欢迎来到班主任大眼睛看有话小孩频道，我是班主任 Joyce。 今天我们要介绍中阶阅读109年国中会考英文阅读试题，以新闻英文的方式介绍杨氏姐弟的便当车人生逆转胜的故事。本期节目中会分为三个部分，节目开始班主任会介绍这篇阅读故事，之后再放上阅读中出现教育部规定的2000单字以及会考会补充的文法，而最后会再带到阅读试题三题来测试前方观众的英文阅读能力。想增进英文阅读能力的前方观众，如果准备好了就快来观看我们的节目哦。关于这篇新闻，在叙述2014年5月30日出现在纽约市曼哈顿53街一条大排长龙的队伍，在一台美食便当车前等待午餐，而菜单上你可以发现炸鸡腿便当、排骨便当、猪肉水饺、茶叶蛋等受欢迎的台湾美食。而这辆外形亮眼的台湾美食便当车是由一对台湾裔美国籍的姐弟 Thomas Young、 杨家豪和 Diane Young、 杨佩珊所经营。在当时便当车还算是新兴产业，因此杨氏姐弟的便当车在当时可是说是第一台销售台湾美食的便当车哦。谈到开设便当车的原因，杨家豪表示，在2008年刚毕业于财经系的他，当时整体社会经济情况没有很好，因为2007年到2008年刚好遇到金融危机，所以杨家豪在当时找工作没有很顺遂的情况下，萌生了创业的念头，利用曾经是厨师的父亲过世后所留下的保险金，以及家族的独特食谱配方，开始了他的便当车创业之旅。在创业早期，杨家豪并不是将车子命名为便当车，而是以 cravings 渴望为餐车名字。然而 cravings 这个字在英文里会让人误以为只贩售中式点心而非中餐，因此生意刚开始的时候还蛮惨淡的。发现问题的杨家豪开始着手更改车身，变更为淡蓝色基底搭配台湾国花梅花，并将原本 cravings 的名称改为便当。而这样一改，果然生意有了起色。现在杨氏兄弟的便当车在两个小时大约可卖上150盒的便当哦。难道杨氏姐弟对于餐车的下一步计划为何呢？他们希望有朝一日能有个台湾小吃街，就像中国城、韩国小镇或小意大利那样的聚落出现。看完以上杨氏姐弟便当车的故事，班主任觉得只要有颗灵活的脑袋，不必凡事遵循传统方式规划，良好的学习态度搭配遇到挫折积极正向面对问题并努力解决，相信假以时日一定能找出属于一片自己的蓝海哦。好啦，以上是109年国中会考英文阅读摘要，如果想要看更深入杨氏姐弟便当车的故事英文版，可以参考班主任连结 Taipei Times 做更深入的延伸阅读哦。永浩英语单字公园
Perfect English Vocabulary Park Number 1 Lunchbox
便当盒
Lunchbox Number 2 Fried Chicken
炸鸡
Fried Chicken Number 3 Pork Dumplings
猪肉水饺
PorkDumplings. Number 4. Food truck.
餐车
Food truck. Number 5. Few.
少的
Few. Number 6. Little.
少的
Little. Number 7. National.
国家的
National. Number 8. Notice.
注意
Notice. Number 9. Block.
街区
Block. Number 10. Happen.
发生
Happen.
永浩英语文法小站
Perfect English Grammar Station.
Few 和 little 的使用方式，国中会考会考 few 和 little 的比较，在中文都是少的意思，但 few 后面接可数名词， little 后面接不可数名词，所以我们可以用 few people would stop by and try their food。 句子中中文的意思为很少人会停下来试试看他们的食物， few people 指的是很少人，单数为 person， 复数为 people 为可数名词。 另外一个例句 ，There will be a little rain this week. 这周雨量稀少。A rain 为不可数名词，因此前面加 little。
109年国中会考便当车英文阅读试题。
Taiwanese Biendang in Manhattan, New York City, May 30th, 2014, by Eva Schmidt. During lunchtime on 53rd Street, you'll see a long line of people in front of a Taiwanese food truck for their biendang, a Taiwanese word for lunchbox. On the menu, you can find fried chicken with rice, pork dumplings, tea eggs, and other popular Taiwanese dishes.The owners of this food truck are Thomas and Diana Yang, two Taiwanese Americans. This brother-sister team started their business in 2009. Back then, there were a few Taiwanese restaurants in the city and several thousand food trucks, but the Yangs were the first to sell Taiwanese food on a food truck. At first, business was slack. People thought they were just another Chinese food truck, and the food truck's name, Cravings,often made people think of desserts, not lunch. Few people would stop by and try their food. I couldn't even give away free food, said Thomas. To catch people's eye, they painted their truck blue and drew Taiwan's national flower, the plum blossom, on it. They also changed the food truck's name to Biendang. Soon, people started to notice them, and business finally got better.Now, on a good day, they can sell about 150 biendangs in about 2 hours. What does the news story say about the Yang's food truck?
A. What people love about their food. B. What made them start their business. C. How they make delicious fried chicken. D. How they fixed their business problems. 这里的答案是 D. How they fixed their business problems. 他们是如何改善他们的生意问题。整篇文章共分三段，而其中两段大篇幅的讨论杨氏姐弟如何创立便当车和改善便当车生意，所以这题答案为 D， 你答对了吗
？What does it mean when business is slack?
A. It is bad. B. It is for sale. C. It is growing. D. It is open every day. 这题的答案是 A. It is bad.代表不好的意思 ，slack 这个单字如果不知道，可以借由文章后面得知。刚开始便当车生意不好，所以杨家豪想办法解决生意问题的叙述来得知此题答案。接下来我们来看文章的最后一段。
So what's next for Thomas and Diana? Well, they hope one day there will be a block with Taiwanese food in the city, just like there is a Chinatown, a Koreatown, and a little Italy.And their Biendang food truck might just help to make that happen. What does that mean in the news story?
A. A Taiwanese restaurant. B. A second Taiwanese food truck. C. A city block that sells Taiwanese food. D. A business that is popular across the country. 这题的答案是 C.A city block that sells Taiwanese food. 有一个可以销售台湾食物的街区，而这个答案可以从记者问杨氏姐弟对便当车想法的答案来推论。他们回答，想要未来有个可以贩售台湾食物的街区，就像中国城、韩国小镇和小意大利那样的聚落。而 that 就代表他们未来发展的梦想，而便当车或许可以帮助他们实现这个梦想。好啦，今天的节目就到这边，希望前面的观众借由本集节目可以增加一点英文能力，以及得到一些小励志的故事。当我们碰到困难，其实只要努力学习并想办法解决，相信你也可以找到自己的一片蓝海，就像杨氏姐弟的便当车一样。那我们今天节目就到这里，如果喜欢我们的节目的前方观众，请按赞分享加订阅。如果想要上更深入的英文课程，欢迎到永浩柜台报名英语课程。那我们下集见咯，拜拜。